Hey, dude, let's get going. We're gonna miss rehearsals.
I got time. I'll be there.
Hey, whatever.
Taking up space.
Whatever. I'm sorry. It was just a joke.
And I say that every time.
I.
Mr. Spielberg, not in the hallway.
So good of you to join us, JT. Ready, and 5, 6, 7, 8. That's it, everyone. Good job. Don't slow down. JT, I'm glad to see you early and dance. On a scale of 1-2, can we actually do this in front of an audience? I'll give it a...
Ugh, you do this every time, and it's still not funny.
We both know it's hilarious. Now quiet. I think we're ready to perform.
Yeah!
That's it. We're done. Make sure to be here on time at 5 p.m. tomorrow to start getting into performance outfits and so we can get some show makeup on you as well.
Yes.
Hey now, you all are going to dance beautifully. We need to make sure you look good as well. And settle down. It's only a little bit of powder to stop you going under the lights and eyeliner to make your eyes pop.
Do the people in the back need to do it too?
There aren't any kids in the back. Everyone has a moment to shine.
Can I just stand in the back, please?
Yeah, can she just stand in the back?
Well, on that note, go get changed, have a good dinner, and don't stay up late watching Quick Clock.
So, do you want to come over tonight and work on our social project? If we don't get this done, Miss Clem is going to lose her mind.
I can't tonight. I have to babysit my sisters. Our parents are doing the weekly wee time.
What about our wee time? Or better yet, an opportunity for some new wee time.
What? No, I mean, shut up.
You know, them who shall not be named also has social homework.
Babysitting.
Wait a minute. I'm a genius. Okay. All you have to do is like kind of feed the kids and like be there in case the house burns down. So what if we take a selected group of individuals and invite them over to do some homework?
Do my feelings mean nothing to you?
Not when I truly know what your heart wants, which is to hang out with your bestie and the person of your dreams.
You know, this is cliche, right? The parents going out and the teenagers at the house throwing some sort of gathering. It's like a start to a bad thriller movie.
Excuse me? It's a solid B-rated movie at least. Or it could make a pretty great after-school film. Nah.
Fine. I'll do it.
Okay, you will not regret this.
I'm just saying, I see no problem with it.
Of course you don't.
Yeah, you don't.
I don't, so explain it to me.
Even if we did, you still wouldn't understand.
Yeah, wouldn't understand.
That hurts.
Oh, he's hurt.
Yeah, he's hurt.
We don't want to wear makeup.
Yeah, no makeup.
But you two wear makeup all the time.
You take that back.
Yeah, take that back.
You do though, and because of that, I thought it would be okay to wear a little bit of makeup for the dance show.
See, you do this every time.
Yeah, every time.
No, I don't.
You always find some clever way to prove that the way I think is wrong and that I should just think like you.
Yeah, it's actually quite insecure of you, Kev.
Don't you mean insensitive?
Whatever.
And no, I don't.
Yes, you do.
You do.
Not all the time.
Fine, not all the time. Wait, did it just happen?
Of course not. But you wear makeup all the time and you look great when you do.
Of course we do. That wasn't even a question, but it's not the same. I mean, do you even know us?
Yeah, do you even know us?
We don't wear makeup, we cosplay. It's completely different.
Yeah, completely different.
That's it, talk to Mrs. Polstein. I'm sure she'll be fine with a couple of the dancers being cosplayers. I mean, we're doing High School Musical. Schools have all different types of people.
You're right. We could totally do that.
Yeah, totally.
And since you both know how to do makeup, you could help, like, me and everyone else.
I never thought of that.
Of course. And you'll be pivotal to this performance now.
Yeah, pivotal.
So pivotal.
I like the sound of that.
Yeah. What does it mean?
Homework night at Megan's starting at 6:30. Bring snacks and your laptops. Also, there'll be a slight responsibility in dealing with children, so be in your best behavior. See you tonight.
What just happened?
I think we were just invited over to Megan's house.
I mean, like, I know she's in our class and all, but I don't even know where she lives. You?
Here's my dress. See you tonight.
Sure. This is what they warned us about in health class, isn't it?
Yeah, health class.
Yup.
Okay, but seriously, what is wrong about trying to do a remix of her school dance song?
Three things. We're doing High School Musical, Paulson doesn't want us to, and you're making a remix.
You have no faith in me.
Not true. I have no faith in this.
What's taking so long?
It's Friday, and I want to go home.
DJ Lemon here wants to do some sort of remix for our final dance number.
Well, that's dumb.
Thank you! That's what I said.
Why am I friends with you?
Because we grew up next door to each other.
We're not friends.
Just listen, okay?
Let's go.
How are we gonna make a remix of High School Musical? Wow. Okay, I stand corrected.
Yeah, that didn't suck in the slightest.
Thank you.
You gotta play that for Mrs. Paulson or something. Maybe she'll put it in the curtain call or something.
Maybe another time.
Why do you even make these mixes if you don't show anyone? Everyone loved it. Kari loved it.
Or didn't say I loved it.
Kari said something nice about it.
That's true.
Nah, my parents aren't yet big fans of how much time I spend playing on my computer with my silly beats.
Well, what do your parents know?
I mean...
Shut up.
Can we please go now?
Mitch, that was amazing. You are coming to the homework hang tonight. And you can DJ. I want to hear all your tunes now. And Iris, you need to come too. Oh, hi, Kara.
Rochelle.
Well, see you tonight. Bye-bye!
Did that actually just happen?
Yep. Rachel invited us to a thing tonight.
I heard that part. But why?
I'm not going.
Hey, so Rachel's been inviting everyone, but forgetting that not everyone knows where I live. So, here. I hope you all come. Should make for a weird night.
I won't be.
I will be going. Sounds like a interesting story. What? It's not like we had any other plans.
I do.
Me too.
No, you don't.
So wait, like, is this for real?
I wouldn't mind knowing that too.
Oh, it's real. We all have a social project due soon anyways, and surprise, surprise, we like to get our work in on time. Plus, Megan's parents aren't going to be home tonight.
Your parents aren't home? Is this a party?
You know what? I think I am free. Mind if I invite some of my friends?
Hi, Kari.
It's not a party.
Yeah, you can't have a party with 7 people.
Loop's right.
8 people.
What?
Yeah, what?
There are 8 of us. You forgot to count yourself.
Why would I need to count myself? I know I'm going to be there.
Yeah, I'm going to be there.
But you are still a person who is taking up space.
The people part is questionable.
Did Kari just talk to us?
You know, I wasn't sure at first, but I'm definitely going now.
A gathering when the parents are gone. Sounds a bit cliche, you know?
Wait, that's what I said.
Kev's right. So cliche.
Yeah, and super sus, too.
Doesn't matter what it is. It's happening, okay?
I'm just saying, you should DJ our next dance. You'd be really great at it. And we don't need some 20-plus-year-old trying to say they know TikTok songs. We already have Miller in the building doing that. And we don't need to hire someone for that.
I mean, I can't. I just...
You don't want to suck?
It's not that. I mean, I already have Kari and my parents telling me that, so...
There is no way I'm missing tonight. Hey, Mitch. Guess what Rachel just told me.
Hey, Mitch, why don't you not? And Iris, please restrain yourself. And Rachel, I hope you get 0 likes in your next post.
You can't be mad at me for telling the truth. I'm just trying to make tonight more fun.
Dude, I found the sandwich, therefore I should have it.
Yeah, well, I smelt it, which is why you found it.
Guys, can you believe this? Someone left the sandwich here, like, half full.
Yeah, half full.
That's right, Kari. We're optometrists.
That's optimist. You complete and utter idiots!
Awesome!
Yeah, awesome!
Is anyone else getting one of those bad feelings about this?
I mean, bad as in I know I shouldn't, but I really want to punch those two.
No, I'm getting it too.
Like, everything is different, but the same.
Yeah, like we're in the
upside down or something. Hey, you like...
Stranger Things? It's one of my favorite shows.
Is this seriously happening right now? Between you two?
don't ruin this for me.
Don't you mean them?
No, just no.
Hey, shouldn't we be getting out of here or something? Maybe we should check the front doors to see if anyone else is here.
Good idea. Maybe they just thought everyone left.
It's a Friday afternoon. When is a school ever shut down like this? This early?
Maybe there was a storm. Yeah, storm.
Well, whatever it is, Mitch is right. This place is giving me the creeps.
It's like they're stuck or something. They're just not budging.
You can't be serious.
Sorry, it's okay. Well,
wait, where's Luke? He's usually right beside me. Where is he?
It's okay. He's probably just in the gym still.
He may have forgotten something.
Or got distracted by the echo.
So what are we gonna do now?
We're gonna find a way out of here. That's what.
And how do you plan on doing that?
I'm open for suggestions.
He wasn't there.
He's gone.
What do you mean, gone?
Like, he wasn't there? He did know we're coming to the atrium, right?
Of course, he's not an idiot.
Well...
We'll find him.
We will. I mean, the front door is locked, so it's safe to assume they all are. He couldn't have left the school.
How about we split up and check the school?
Split up?
We'll cover more ground that way, find him faster, and get out of here.
Cool! Nothing like splitting up into groups in the middle of a locked-up school, where one of us just happened to disappear. That doesn't sound...
cliché.
Oh look, you're finishing each other's
sandwiches. Luke used to finish my sandwiches.
Well, let's get to it then. Okay, you and I will go to the library, and Kevin and Megan, you'll go to the seventh wing. Well, Iris and Mitch go to the eighth wing.
And what about me?
You can stay here, just in case you come back.
She's coming with us. Good luck, everyone. Oh, and if it helps, Luke loves the smell of cinnamon.
How exactly was that supposed to help us?
No clue. Wait, Kari, isn't your hand lotion cinnamon smelling?
We're all gonna die.
So, you and Luke are really close, huh?
Yeah, we're family.
Brother from another mother?
No, we're cousins, actual family.
Oh, really? I didn't know that.
How could you not? We have the same last name.
Trip, darling. I don't know your real first name, let alone your last name.
Trip!
Pretty good friend of yours, huh?
My best friend. Why?
She sure is...
pretty, smart, talented, outgoing.
I was gonna say terrifying, but I'm glad you say such nice things about your friends. I wonder what Tripp says about me. So, is it true what Rachel said?
What? No, not even slightly. I mean, you're nice and all, but your face is stupid and yuck and whatever. I don't have a crush on you.
So, she did not say that. You have a crush on me?
She didn't say that?
So, she did not say that you have a crush on me. This is the first that I'm hearing that you have a crush on me. Like, we barely even talk, and yet you have a crush on me.
Will you stop saying that?
Fine, fine, fine. It's just, I feel very complimented by this news, is all.
So, what did you say about me?
That you are the most amazing person ever, and that if I let anything happen to you, that she would... I'm just gonna spare you from the details, because it's pretty gruesome and I don't want to relive them.
Fine by me.
Right.
This is the first door that's unlocked. What should we do?
Go in, I guess.
You know, that's so... cliche.
A sudden chill came over me. There was a loud gasp from the girl beside me. I half turned, keeping my eyes fixed upon the shape in front of me.
from which a darkness was sprouting out of it, like tentacles, pushing my back against the door. I saw astonishment giving horror on the faces of the people about me. I heard inarticulate exclamations on all sides. There was a general movement backwards. I saw my friend, struggling, still, on the edge of the room. I found myself alone and saw the people on the other side of the class running off. I looked again at the person. An ungovernable terror gripped me. I stood petrified and staring. A big black rounded bulk, the size, perhaps, of a bear, was rising slowly and painfully out of the shape. As it bulged up and caught the light, it glistened like wet oil. Two large dark-colored eyes were regarding me steadfastly.
The mass that framed them.
The head of the thing was rounded. And had, one might say, a face.
There was a mouth under the eyes.
The lipless room.
Which quivered and panted and dropped saliva.
The whole creature heaved and pulsated convulsively. The lank tentacular appendage gripped the edge of the shape.
I believe that is all for today, class. You may go for lunch now.
Get out of here, Megan!
Get out of here, Megan!
I can't just leave you.
Go!
No!
No!
I was seriously walking around this empty school looking for that empty-headed one.
He's a friend.
Not my friend.
We would do the exact same thing if it was anyone else.
Including you.
Especially her.
Aw, who's this?
Symbiosis is defined as a close, prolonged association between two or more different organisms of different species that may, but does not necessarily, benefit each member. In layman's terms, a relationship, a mutual benefit, or dependence. When people are working together, they're often working in symbiosis. In contrast, a parasitic relationship is one in which one organism, the parasite, lives off of another organism, the host, harming it and possibly causing death. The parasite lives on or in the body of the host.
Well, this is messed up.
Although the parasite harms its host, it is in the parasite's best interest not to kill the host, because it relies on the host's body and body functions, such as digestion and blood circulation, to live.
Okay, time to leave.
On it. Little witch, I'm trying! The door's locked!
A parasite and its host evolve together.
The parasite adapts to its environment
by living in and using the host,
thereby making us stronger.
We like being stronger.
We need to go!
I know that! Hurry up! Hurry up!
Come on, I'm open the door!
It's Iris! Guys! Iris!
Come on! Help her!
Go!
No, Mitch, what are you doing? Get out of there! Guys, get out! No!
Did we just narrowly escape from some weird black shape thingy?
Seems that way.
Aw, man, Luke would have loved to see that.
Trip, I think he did.
What do you mean? You think he saw before he got lost?
Sure he did.
To be or not to be, that is the question. For all the world's a stage and all the men and women merely players. Tomorrow creeps in this petty pace. The quality of our mercy is not strained. Friends, Romans, and countrymen, lend me your ears, for this is the winter of our discontent.
Is this a play?
Do shut up, Trip.
There was a time when all seemed normal, but in the same moment completely abnormal. It is those moments that we love best. It is those moments where we can thrive and grow. People always think they need the regular stuff of life to evolve, but that's not true. It is in the irregular, in the darkness, that one truly finds the freedom to become who or what they're meant to be.
This place sucks.
I don't think this is the play.
Take us, for instance. If not for all the shadows that are put on us, we would be able to do what we do. Believe us,
we can do a lot.
We grow so tired of always chasing and running. Let's make a new beginning and have you join us
from the start.
Hey, are you Lime, like the real Lime, or something else?
Something more.
Well, drama's never been my thing, so we're just gonna...
My real name's Alex. People just call me Trip because I triple R!
They got Kari and Mitch.
Trip too.
We have to get out of here.
But how? I don't know. I'm open for suggestions.
Let's go.
I got it. We have to get to Trip and Loop's lockers.
But why? How will that help?
They're cosplayers. They dress up.
They're nerds. Represent. Great. How is this supposed to help us?
Trip's character's like a barbarian or something, and Loop's like a paladin.
I know I said I liked you and all, but if you don't speed this up...
They both have hammers.
This is the longest explanation ever.
Is this why you're friends with those two? We can use the weapons to smash out of here.
Exactly.
Nerds for the win.
Just another thing no one's gonna believe when we get out of here.
I'm so tired of the game. It is time to end it. Thank you.
person to hang out with a school like that.
Megan, it's okay.
Don't worry.
Let's go call your parents.
I could not foresee this thing.